Hi, everyone. So, how many folks here feel that they understand what the cloud is, what cloud computing is? It's a technology company, so I suspect it's a higher percentage of hands than usual. Okay, so here's what it really is. The only thing it boils down to is shared and expandable computing resources on the internet. Nice and simple. It is not something that's really complicated, really hard to understand. You know, it requires a lot of technical background. It's simply this. Now, Wikipedia's definition is a little more complex. It says cloud computing is a type of internet-based computing that provides shared computing resources and data to computers and other devices on demand. So, for many people, what that means these days is simply having photos on the internet, having file storage like using Box, email like Gmail, and other services like Office 365. And sometimes these are just a part of the computer. Many people don't even know that you're actually really using the cloud when you're doing some of these things, like email, for example. Now, so I'm going to go through a little bit of history to help put the cloud into some kind of context and help better understand it. So there's electrical utilities. Many years ago, centuries as a matter of fact, if you ran a factory, you had to produce your own electricity. That's why when you see these wheels near all these rivers, what you're doing is they're producing electricity for this factory. Now, if this factory grew, they had to figure out some way to get more electricity. And of course, they had to maintain it. They had to make sure it was up and running all the time. And it was, it was a major aspect of their business and a major problem. Some companies said, wow, what if we were able to centralize that, get economies of scale, and using a network or electrical grid to get this to these various factories, then it would make it very convenient for all of these factories, and they would have expandability. Are you seeing the correlation between the cloud and electrical utilities already? So it simply became centralized and expandable and essentially on demand, because as the factories required more power, it was just there. And it was a centralized utility company and they could provide it. So even before the cloud became what the cloud is today, companies could outsource their data centers and the computing power requirements. But you would do something like sign a contract with IBM for 5 years, locked in, and have to put millions of dollars down on the table. And if you needed to make changes to that, you had to go through change orders, you had to wait for many months to actually get new servers spun up and get them added to the network and all the other stuff that it takes to get physical hardware shipped and put into a data center and connected and all set up for it. But now, along comes Amazon. And Amazon says, you want some of these resources, computing resources? I'll charge you by the hour. And in many cases, to actually spin up a computer, you're looking at cents, usually not dollars. I mean, dollars are once you start getting these bigger and bigger computers. But again, it's per hour. So you could potentially have a bill at the end of the month for what computing resources you needed for less than a dollar. You need to spin up one box for 1 hour to do a quick software test and shut it down again. You get a bill for probably 62 cents or something on Amazon. It's incredible. And back to the definition. You know, what Amazon was providing was on-demand, shared and expandable computing resources. Sure, you're going to start off with one box for an hour or two. Then you need that box all the time. You need 10 boxes, you need 100 computers on there, you need them networked, and of course the data that's going to be going onto these computers is going to be getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and simply, as you require more and more space, it gets, Amazon automatically provides that for you, and they simply send you a bigger and bigger bill. So it is always there for you, and it's expandable and on demand. It's a wonderful thing. Now, where did the term cloud computing come from? mean, it doesn't really look like clouds per se. But what it actually was all these network engineers would be trying to describe what they have, and they would be drawing a cloud. And they would be putting various computing resources inside of that little thing. What else do you do? I mean, you draw a box to put it in? Well, not really, you know, it's kind of expandable and you want to stretch it and stuff. So that's where the term came from. There's various speculation as to who first used it, you know, that term. So if I want to even speculate, I'd say that. But that's where the term cloud came from. Exactly, like doing those diagrams. Like this. What do I want to do? I want to draw a little thing like this to put various things inside of it. And then from inside of that, I mean from outside of that network, you have various things connecting to it. So, Prisma. I am the project manager for the migration from our traditional data centers to the cloud. And what are we getting out of that? We're getting huge benefits from doing that, from taking advantage of these expandable on-demand resources. We're getting capacity on demand. We're getting data locality. Because the cloud is all over the globe, and Amazon has servers all over the globe, you know, so does other cloud providers, but of course, you know, Amazon does too. We're going to have our European clients' data stored in Europe. Now, North American client data stored in North America. And more these days, countries are actually requiring that data is stored locally. We get to take advantage of new technologies as they come online. We get much faster time to market. Rather than having to wait 6 months to have servers shipped and put in a data center, we can just spin it up and click a button. We have improved availability and durability because Amazon has the scale to build absolutely amazing infrastructure. Linda just gave me the red hat, so I'm not going to get into what infrastructure as code is or software as a service. But I will say this. The cloud is really a basic concept. Again, shared and expandable computing resources on the internet on demand. And it has significant benefits to both companies and individuals. Any questions about the cloud or about the points I brought up here? John.
I do. You talked about some great benefits of cloud computing. What are some of the risks?
Security. Certainly security. Yeah. Security obviously is a big risk. But the thing is, security is a risk no matter where you're putting something. So if you're putting something, if you're connecting a computer to the internet, you have risk instantly. The thing Amazon actually goes through huge effort to ensure that their systems are secure. Now they can't do everything because it's what they call a shared security model. So they will provide the basis for security, and they provide it as well as any data center ever could, and certainly as well as any individual company could actually provide. And then you have to make sure you don't do stupid things in the meantime, like open up ports, all ports to the whole world, for example. So you need to lock some things down, follow some basic best practices, and the cloud becomes secure. Great question. Thanks.
What are some of the things that we can do to learn more about the cloud?
I think you could start using it. I think it'd be great. One great thing. I mean, you're probably already using the cloud and you just don't know it. But if you want to get into it from a more professional business perspective, open up an Amazon account. They have something called a free tier. And you can actually utilize quite a number of resources and never pay a penny. You can spin up servers, you can have disk space, and you can build up web servers, you can host your own service, you know, sites, and so on and so forth, and you can do it all for free using Amazon's free tier. Google's a big one, and
Microsoft.
Microsoft.